What's going on, guys? So I was thinking to myself, what can I make my next video about? I was sitting on the couch, I was cleaning up my desktop a bit, getting some files ready for school. I said to my wife, what do you think I should make my next video on? And she goes, well, make it on your custom desktop. And I go, yeah, I know, I'm gonna edit it on my custom desktop. And she goes, no. Why don't you make it on your custom desktop? The one I spent so many hours making. And I thought to myself, you know what? That's a really good idea. I can show you how to make custom icons, get rid of those pesky system notifications, clean up your start menu, and get rid of that ugly recycling bin. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna get you all cleaned up, get you ready to take on the world, get you ready to be productive, and feel good about your desktop.
Okay, so first we're gonna go to the start menu, search themes, open the themes menu, navigate to color, scroll down, hit that button, it'll say dark. Next, we'll go up and go to custom color, take that pretty little bar and move it all the way to the left till it's completely black. Here I search for Chrome, right click, open file location. This will open File Explorer window with a shortcut to Chrome. Right click that, send to desktop as a shortcut, then we'll do the same with Spotify. So search, right click, open file location, once again, send that to the desktop as a shortcut, then we'll repeat that with Word and OneNote. So you open file location, find the shortcut, send to desktop as shortcut, and then repeat as needed for whichever applications you use, browsers, productivity, whatever. Next, we'll open up File Explorer. As you'll notice, you can't open the file location. Instead, what you'll have to do is actually open File Explorer, go to your OS, Windows, and then start typing Explorer. You'll find explorer.exe. Send that to the desktop as a shortcut. Next thing we'll want to do is find the appropriate icons or create our own. Iconarchive.com will be in the description. They've got a ton of great icons. So to start, we're going to search for Word. Once you've found your icon, I think we find it on the third page here. Mouse over it and you'll see a .ico. So you'll want to click that to download your .ico file and save that. So you can then minimize that window and cut the icon. You'll then want to navigate to My Documents, create a new folder and call it Icons, Custom Icons, whatever you'd like. Inside that folder, create two new folders named Icons and Links. Now, drag all the shortcuts from the desktop into the Links folder. Once you've done that, navigate to the Icons folder, the sub-icons folder, and paste that icon that you just downloaded in there. Navigate back to the links folder, find your Word shortcut, go properties, change icon, browse, and then find your icon, click apply, okay, and now your link should have your newly found icon. You can then unpin your old icon from your taskbar, find your new shortcut with the new icon and pin that to your taskbar. Now, I already had some icons that I custom made for OneNote, so you'll see OneNote, Spotify, and Google Chrome all happening a little quickly here. It's the same process as it was with Word. By the way, these will be available for download just right there in the description. File Explorer, it's a little more complicated. Open File Explorer, find it in the taskbar, right click on the little File Explorer, properties, should find change icon, then browse, choose your icon, and finally pin it to the taskbar. Now, to get rid of those pesky system tray icons, we'll right click on the desktop, go personalize, find taskbar, scroll right down under notification area, select which icons appear on the taskbar. First off, always show all icons, we want that off. Next, find the icons you want to see at all times. Everything else, turn it off. I generally keep power, network, and Wi-Fi on my laptop. Okay, so once you've done that, you can exit that and we'll go and install Rainmeter. So there's a link in the description for Rainmeter. It's a program that allows you to customize your desktop, download skins, clocks, dynamic widgets, things like that. So click on download final, open that up, install the standard installation. Once that's completed, click finish. And we'll go into the system tray, find Rainmeter, little raindrop, open that. Under Illustro, we want to disable all of the .ini files that are currently enabled. Once you've got that done, click the link into the description to download Translucent Taskbar. Open that, install it, and once that is done, go on back to Rainmeter, find Translucent Taskbar, and load up that skin. You can exit out of everything there, and you'll notice that your taskbar is completely see-through now, which looks really, really sharp. Next thing, to get rid of that search bar, that Cortana search bar, you simply right-click the taskbar, go up to Cortana, and click Hidden. Really helps clean up the taskbar a bit. So what we're gonna do next is go wherever you saved the background folder, which is in the description, find the background, and right-click set as desktop background. So to make our icons all pretty in the center, what we're gonna do is you first wanna unlock your taskbar. Once you've done that, you wanna go to Toolbars, Add Links. You'll see some little adjustment lines, so drag that all the way over to the Start menu and your other icons should pop out the other side. There'll then be an adjustment bar you can drag, so you can drag your icons as close to centered as possible. Next, you'll right-click, disable Show Text, disable Show Titles, and relock your taskbar. Your icons should now be centered, crisp, clean, and beautiful. This next part here is just gonna be how to get rid of your recycling bin. So on your desktop, you'll go down to Personalize. Once you're in Personalize, you'll wanna go down to Themes, Desktop Icon Settings on the right, and just uncheck Recycle Bin. Click Apply, okay. And once you exit out of there, you should have no trash on that pretty little desktop of yours. Finally, what we're gonna do is clean up this Start menu. So when you open Start, you should have a whole bunch of little tiles. If you right click on them, you can unpin them from Start. Once you've unpinned each and every one of them, unless you use them, that's fine too. Once you've unpinned them all, you should be able to just grab the edge and drag it right over till you've got this nice, slim little Start menu. And the final product, this crisp, clean, beautiful desktop. I hope you enjoyed this. I love creating things like this, and I'm really happy to be able to share it.
So there you have it. Gorgeous desktop, crisp, clean, centered icons, minimal clutter. I'm really happy that I could bring that to you guys. For me, it's one of my favorite things to do is to just tweak and perfect my desktops. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, like, subscribe, like. You know what to do, and I'll see you guys next time.